Jesus, because he and he alone is worthy of that. We thought about, you know, in our praise and our worship and our time of sharing, the passage that kept coming back to me, I got to tell you, I probably picked up my Bible 4 or 5 times, and I was going to come up here and read this passage, but it's in, it's very familiar, 2 Chronicles chapter 20. You know it, right? Jehoshaphat and great host was against them, and Jehoshaphat says something so profound in verse number 12, I think it is. Now, I'm not preaching this. I'm not even preaching yet. This is the extended version of the time of sharing. But in verse number 12, Jehoshaphat says, "O our God, will you not execute judgment on them," them being the enemy, this great host that had come against Judah. He said, or Israel, he says, for we are powerless against this great horde that is coming against us. We do not know what to do, but our eyes are on you. I think in the King James Version, it says, it may say our eyes are fixed on you. What there's this, I don't know that I want to call it a concept. I think it's greater than a concept and probably even greater than a precept. Is probably principle in scripture. But what Jehoshaphat says is what we need to do all the time. In 21st century, I don't want to say theology, but maybe exegetical work, it's really this idea of vertical ministry. Vertical ministry. That what Jehoshaphat was saying was that there is nothing we can do on the horizontal plane. We are outnumbered, we are overpowered, we are overmatched. And so, Lord, I'm not going to even focus on what outnumbers me. I'm going to focus on the one who can deliver me.
Amen.
Here's the thing. All horizontal ministry that bears fruit that remains, not just that bears fruit, because there are people who are doing ministry that bears fruit. The caveat, Jesus said, is fruit that
remains.
Things that make you go. Fruit that remains. Because you can fly up and you can flash. And you can make a sparkle and give off a lot of smoke. And if you're not careful, you'll fizzle. I'm preaching better than you said, amen. And so what the requirement of the kingdom when it comes to fruit is fruit that remains. Not shiny. I don't know about y'all. Yeah, I'm probably not a great method to pick apples, but I'll look for red and shiny.
Right.
And it's probably not the best method. This is probably why Tony don't send me to buy fruit. I'm looking for perfect appearance, perfect on the outside. Perfect looking doesn't mean
right, Pastor.
All right.
That's right.
Yeah. You don't stop falling prey to glitz and glamour.
That's right.
Stop. Stop. I'm begging you, stop. Oh, they look so good. They sound so good. They got it all together. So what?
Come on.
So what? Where's the substance in the thing?
That's right.
Where is the substance? Where is the edification? Where is the building up of the body? Because if it's something that only points to the shiny one, then there's a problem. Are you okay? I'm only sharing this because I love you.
Amen.
And I really want to help. And I'm right. It's right. Not I'm right. It's right.
That's right.
And I'm mandated to do it.
Amen.
And if I don't do it, then I've got to stand before God and give an accounting as to why I didn't do it.
Right.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
And there are a couple conversations that God and I are not going to have when I stand before him. And one of them is, why didn't you tell my people what was true?
Amen.
We ain't having that conversation. Excuse the poor grammar. But we ain't having that conversation. Just because it's dressed up and smells good and looks good don't mean it's good. Pray to God that we would come to a place where we would stop being superficial. And so this concept, this idea of vertical ministry, that all fruitful, lasting, fruitful, horizontal ministry is birthed out of vertical ministry. Do you understand? It good horizontal ministry doesn't even come from my capacity to study, my ability to regurgitate information that I've taken in. It doesn't even come from that. It doesn't come from glitz. And it's not just anointing. It comes from being in the throne room with the Father. That's where it comes from. And if you ain't been in the throne room, I don't need you standing up over me. I don't care how much your shoes cost. I don't care how many tailors got together and knitted your suit together. It just don't matter. Look, somebody told me, say, you need to be involved in vertical ministry. Vertical ministry. Vertical ministry. Ministry is this ready admission that whatever is before me is too much for me. I can't handle it. That's what Ann was saying this morning. I couldn't handle it. And you, there are some things you just got to say, Lord.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
You see? Isn't that what Hezekiah did? When the Assyrians and Sennacherib came up against them and they wrote a letter, Dear Hezekiah, you cut off. Dear Hezekiah, we're coming in there and we're going to wring your neck. And all the gods you serve, he can't deliver you from us. He can, you might as well surrender. P.S. If you don't, I'm going to whoop your. And Hezekiah got the letter and went right to the house of the Lord. And he engaged in vertical ministry. And he opened up the letter and he put it on the altar. And said, now if you really are the one who has eyes that go to and fro, searching the depths of the earth, read this. Because this is what they're saying about you. You've got to come to a place where you stop taking things personally. One of the reasons that disallows me from releasing a thing to God is I take it personally. Boy, you're preaching good here. When you take it personally, then you feel like you gotta vindicate yourself. You've gotta represent yourself. You've gotta defend yourself. It ain't about me. Look at Mark. This is all about you. What can I do? What can I say? Who am I in the grand scheme of things? What do I have that I haven't received? I didn't give birth to anything. Lord, my eyes are on you. My eyes are on, can I ask you a question? What you looking at? What are you looking at? What are you looking at? Sister Deborah could have spent time all weekend long looking at $53. What are you looking at?
That's right.
I told you before, I told you a few weeks ago, you go where you're looking. You don't believe me? Get in the car. Get in the car. Get behind the wheel. Put it in drive and then look away. And then when you look back, you will find that you have drifted in the direction that you're looking. I ask you again, what are you looking at? What are you looking at? Jehoshaphat said, I ain't even looking at this great horde. It ain't no need in looking at them. I can't, ain't nothing we can do with nothing out there. You have to resolve that there is nothing you can do with anything out there. The scripture says, set your affection on things above, not on these earthly things. Fix your eyes on, the writer to the Hebrews said, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. We spend too much time looking to and talking to people who can't do anything for you anyway. And so Jehoshaphat and the children of Israel engaged in vertical ministry. We you know, I thank the Lord that I do need a word, and I praise God that He ministers to me through you, but all too often we're looking to give a word before we even
got one.
Later, Jehoshaphat took it to the next level. And, he sent the choir out. It was really based on strategy.
Yes, sir.
The edicts and the tactics of warfare doesn't make a whole lot of sense. But here is this vast army. This amalgamation of nations that have come, wasn't even one nation, or several that had come against them. And you're going to take a defensive position. The thing is that oftentimes what looks one way in the natural is another way in the spiritual. I'm preaching good here now. And so what looked like a tactical error to the generals of those who were against Israel was really the offensive thing of God. And he said, go on, get the praisers out there. Get Judah. What does Judah mean? Praise. You ought to, if you're going to get something, get a praise. We're too busy trying to get advice when you need to get a We trying to borrow money when you need to get a
praise.
We trying to gather opinions when you need to get a
praise.
I will bless the Lord at all times, and His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My God, if you get a praise, you got something. If you get a praise, you've got something that will endure your situation.
Yeah.
If you can get a praise,
yeah, hallelujah.
You get a God who will answer your prayer.
Hallelujah, God, hallelujah.
We're pursuing the wrong thing. I need a praise. I'm going to bless Him. I'm going to bless Him not because He's done something for me. I'm going to bless Him simply because He's good. He's good. Somebody said this morning, if you don't ever do another thing, He's already done enough. He's already done enough for me to praise Him for the rest of my life. He's done enough already. Every morning and at noon and in the evening, Lord, I bless you and I praise you and I thank you. All hell coming against me, but it doesn't matter. Greater is He that is in me.
Yes, yes. Hallelujah.
Look, somebody told me, say, this is vertical ministry. This is vertical ministry right here. This isn't about, you know, can you come over here? I got a word for you. Can you come over here? I got a prayer for you. Listen, I appreciate all of that. That's good and it has its place. But if there's no this is weak and sickly, y'all. Jehoshaphat said, get the worship team together. And somebody said, We already had worship. It's time to take the offering in the service now. We're so rigid and locked in. If God wanted to say something, we would, Lord, it's not time. If you come back next Sunday, and if you're here at 11, because typically we stop worship then, Lord, we'll make about 10 minutes time for you to speak to us. Look at somebody, tell them, say, loosen up, loosen up, loosen up. We can't do that now. It ain't time for that now in the service. But when you're involved in vertical ministry, your ear is to the wind of the Spirit. And whatever the Father says, whenever He says it, I'm going to do it. Isn't that what Mary told them servants? Y'all know they needed that wine. Y'all know they needed it. Y'all know we can't get together without a lubricant. Y'all know they needed that wine. And Mary said, now son, you know they all out. And he said, listen, mama, I love you, but what's that got to do with me? What that got to do with me? That ain't my problem. I'm a guest here. One theologian said they ain't run out of wine until Jesus and the disciples got there. But that's another story. I don't want to go into that. I'll let you wrestle that out with your theology. But when they got there, they ran out. And Mary said, I don't care what you say. I remember what the angel said. Sometimes you just got to step back from your situation and remember the word of the Lord to you. What did God say to you? Stop listening to your circumstances and stop listening to your situation and fall back on the word of God in your life. Lord, what did you say? Jesus said in John 6:63, the word that I speak to you, they are spirit.
Life.
I find my life in the word and not in my situation. I find my life in my revelation. And after a while, there'll be a manifestation. But can you wait for your manifestation? Can you wait for your manifestation? Can you wait trusting and hoping and believing in the one whose word is true? May walk away from Jesus. Sometimes folks give you a smart answer. You just got to walk away from them. You just got to walk away from them. And Mary walked by the servant. She said, oh, by the way, whatever he commands you to do, do it. Do it. Whatever he tells you to do, do it. And the servants was listening and said, I don't think he's going to tell us to do. He told his mama, that ain't my problem. He told his mom, I'm a guest. I'm not supposed to, ain't nobody tell me. You know, you ever been to a, okay, Lord, help me. We deliver now. But you ever gone to a house party where it was BY?
Okay,
y'all. Everybody know what that means?
Yes,
you had to bring your own drink. Jesus said, listen, when I got this invitation, ain't wasn't no BYO. This is a BYO. Affair. No. You invite me to the reception. Everything that I would want, you're supposed to already have at the reception. Y'all know I like cake. Don't have me come over, you ain't got no cake. We had some, pastor, but you know, I want to hear that. The devil is a liar. Amen. Y'all better go get some cake. Mary said, I don't care what you heard him say. Whatever he commands you to do, do it. Do it. And something quickened in Jesus. Why? Because Mary, while she was having a horizontal conversation, she was involved in vertical ministry. When you're involved in vertical ministry, the vertical will supersede the horizontal every time.